In this video, we will learn about guest blogging and using press releases for building backlinks. Let us first look at guest blogging. Guest blogging is about publishing your articles or blog posts on other sites. Normally, we publish blog posts on our own website. But when we do that, we build content, we help Google understand a little bit more about what our site is, and we are able to attract backlinks. So they are important to publish on our own site. When we publish a blog on other sites, we are able to reach new audience, and we are able to get more exposure for our brand and our product. We also get a backlink from publishing guest blogs. There are many sites on the internet looking for good content. There are thousands and thousands of sites which need fresh new content every day. And they don't have resources to pay content writers to write these articles for them. So they rely on people who will make contributions to the site. Guest bloggers. You can also sign up with them and submit your article for publishing on their site. If they like the article, the website will publish it, and along with the article, it'll also publish a byline about you, the author, and in that byline, they'll have a backlink pointing to your website. So you get a backlink. You also get a lot of exposure for your brand because the site where you have published your guest blog, it has its own audience, readership. Maybe a few hundred people, maybe a few thousand people come there every day and read blogs there. And you'll be exposed to a lot of new people who have not heard about you earlier. The typical way to get a backlink from guest blog is to include a link to your site in the byline. Guest blogging is very, very effective and popular. A lot of websites rely on guest bloggers to submit content. And a lot of people rely on guest blogging for both link building as well as generating brand and referral traffic. And this succeeds because both the site which publishes the content and the person who writing the content both benefit. So it's mutually beneficial. But when you are trying to publish yourself on a site, you should select a site which is trusted by Google. And it is free to post guest blogging. Many sites will charge you money to publish your article. Those are not good sites because Google will sooner or later find out that the site uses paid articles and any links from that site will be degraded by Google. When you start doing guest blogging, you may find it difficult to be accepted by big sites. So you start writing for smaller sites. And as you build up your portfolio, you build up the profile, then you start applying to write for bigger sites. People who do it really well will write one or two guest blogs per week. But if you don't have time, because it takes a lot of time to research and write a high quality article. So if you don't have time, even doing two guest blogs a month is pretty good. The advantage of guest blogging is you are also contributing to their site. So you can also demand something in return. And typically, what you demand in return is a backlink with proper anchor text, keyword-rich anchor text, and a do-follow tag. So the site which is publishing your blog post also knows that there has to be something in it for you, the author, and they will be willing to give it to you if you ask for it. Let us figure out how to find guest blogging opportunities. And the best way to do that is use Google to search for sites that are looking for guest bloggers. You search Google with your keyword, plus sign, then the phrase in title, colon, and then in quotes, write for us. What you are telling Google with this phrase is, please show me pages which are relevant to the keyword and where the page title has write for us. So Google will find pages which are relevant to your keyword and where the title tag has the phrase write for us. Normally, a site which is looking for guest bloggers will have a page titled write for us. And Google will be able to find those pages for you using this search term. You can also use a variant of that where instead of write for us, you put contribute to. You'll find fewer sites with this search. But when you run out of sites using write for us, you can try the contribute to. Another search term used is keyword plus in title submit plus in URL blog. So what we are telling Google is find a page that matches my keyword where the title says submit and the URL says blog. So it is asking us to submit a blog. And that is typically done by pages where people are submitting guest blog. Once you have found a list of sites, sort them based on their reputation, authority, and the type of content they publish, and then contact them. If you reach out to 20 or 25 sites, 3 or 4 will accept you. Then you publish for them. Once you start building your portfolio, then more and more sites will start to accept you. So you keep repeating this process every few months, so you keep moving up in the ranking in terms of the kind of site where you are publishing your blog. Let us look at press releases. Press release is basically a news that is created by a company and distributed to news agencies for publishing. So instead of a reporter writing a news, the company itself creates the news and distributes it. It's a very common practice. Businesses will use a press release for many different things. It could have a product launch information, information about an event or report. All public companies do a press release about their quarterly and annual results. If a company is organizing an event, they'll do a press release about it. The idea behind press release is to get wider publicity and coverage. The way it works is the company creates a news release and then distributes it through distribution agencies or news distributors. These news distributors are like a marketplace. On one side are people who are releasing news. On the other side are publications which publish these news items. So these publishers could be newspapers, magazines, news-related sites, blog sites. And these publishers subscribe to feed from the news distributors. And based on their criteria about what kind of news they want to publish, they'll select the news items that they want to publish. Publishers use this news distributor because they have a lot of space to fill in the newspaper or website. And it'll be very expensive to have so many reporters working for them. So they have a core team of reporters that does reporting for them. But there are a lot of things happening that these people cannot cover. And for those things, publishers rely on news distributors. So company creates the news, distributes it to the news distributor, then it reaches the publishers. If the publishers like it, they'll publish it on their website. If you include a link to your site in the news release, then when this news gets published on a website, it'll create a backlink to your site. So if, for example, you do a news release and 20 sites publish it, you'll get 20 backlinks. So as you can see, it can be very effective in building links and also in driving traffic, because every time you do a news release, it is published on some sites. Some people will read the news, they'll click the link and come to your site. So it's a good idea to keep creating periodic news releases. You can create both paid and free news release. The paid news release is distributed by more reputed distributors and therefore picked up by more reputed publishers. The free news is distributed by relatively lesser known news distributors and also picked by smaller websites. The best way to write a news release is to create an article or a blog post kind of news release. So it gives value to the readers and it becomes interesting for news sites to publish it. Always include a link back to your site so you get a backlink and referral traffic. If you write your news release well and you distribute it well, your news story will be picked up by a lot of sites and will lead to extra traffic and links. First, you find a PR site that fits your budget. So if you want free, look for a free news distribution site. If you have some money, look for paid news distribution sites which are within your budget. Some of the paid sites are prnewswire.com, Reuters.com. These are the two leaders in the paid news distribution. Then there are free news distribution sites like openpr.com, onlineprnews.com. You can submit free news releases here. They'll be picked up by some publications. But as I said, they may not be picked up by a lot of bigger sites. So after you have found the news release site, write your news release and submit it, and then it'll be distributed. You can also use Haro. Haro is short for Help a Reporter Out. It is a web service to help reporters find reliable information. This is also a marketplace. When a reporter or a blogger wants to write an article about something, she needs information about the topic. She's not an expert on everything that they write about. Even if she writes about technology, she'll not be an expert about all the different technologies. So she needs to talk to experts to understand trends, benefits, how companies are using these technologies, and so on and so forth. But how does she reach out to these experts? So she joins Haro as a news publisher or reporter. And when she is writing a news, she will submit a query asking for experts to respond to the query. And the query will have questions about, you know, are you using this technology? What are the benefits? So depending on the kind of story she is doing, she'll send out a query. And she uses Haro because it is difficult for her to find out lots of experts. She may know one or two, but it's hard for her to find 10 or 20 experts to interview for her news article or blog post. So she is using Haro. On the other hand, experts are looking for coverage. So you represent a company, you are, let's say, an expert on CRM. You want some news coverage, some media coverage for your company. So you join Haro as an expert. And when you join as an expert, you'll receive the queries that are submitted by reporters or bloggers. And then you can respond to them. So you receive an email 3 times a day, categorized by your expertise area. So you can sign up based on your expertise area, and the reporters will submit the query and they'll identify which category they want to submit it in. For example, finance, business, technology. And then the query will be directed towards experts who have registered with Haro in that category. So the experts will get an email and then they will respond to it. So there are two types of users, reporters or bloggers who need information, and experts or source who provide information to these reporters and bloggers. So when a reporter wants to publish an article or blog, she goes to Haro and submits a query. The query clearly identifies where the article is going to be published, so the responders would know how important or big this can be. The reporter will ask specific information in the form of questions and may also identify what kind of experts she needs to talk to. The email is sent out to registered experts on the topic. When the expert sees the query, he responds to it, answers the questions asked by the reporter in the email, identifies himself, provides link to the website, LinkedIn, Twitter, whatever he wants to be included along with the quote, and emails the response. If the reporter likes the response, she is going to use it in the story. And she's going to quote the expert. So the reporter will then inform the expert that I am going to use your comments. When the story is published, the story will have the quote by the expert. The expert will be identified and a link back will be provided to the website. So to use Haro as an expert, register as an expert in your topic or area, and then you'll start receiving emails. Go through the email queries every day and answer them.